mine a lion ready for his prey, and is mine a lion of wealth that dwelleth in hiding. Arise, O Lord, overtake them and trip their heels. Deliver my soul from ungodly men, thy sword from the enemies of thy hand. O Lord, from thy few do thou separate them from the earth and their lives. Yea, with thy hidden treasures hath their belly been filled. They have satisfied themselves with swine and have left the remnants to their babes. But as for me, in righteousness shall I appear before thy face. I shall be filled when thy glory is made manifest unto me. Unto thee, O Lord, have I lifted up my soul. O my God, in thee have I trusted. Let me never be put to shame, nor let mine enemies laugh me no more. Yea, let none that wait on thee be put to shame. Let them be ashamed which are lawless without a cause. Make thy ways, O Lord, known unto me. Teach me thy paths. Lead me in thy truth, and teach me, for thou art God my Savior. For on thee have I waited all the day long. Remember thy compassions, O Lord, and thy mercies, for they are from everlasting. The sins of my youth and mine ignorances remember not. According to thy mercy, remember thou me, for the sake of thy goodness, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord, therefore will he set a law for them that sin in the way. He will guide the meek in judgment, he will teach the meek his ways. All the ways of the Lord are mercy and truth unto them that seek after his covenant and his testimonies. For the sake of thy name, O Lord, be gracious unto my sin, for it is great. Who is the man that feareth the Lord? He will set him a law in the way which he hath chosen. His soul shall dwell among good things, and his seed shall inherit the earth. The Lord is the strength of them that fear him, and his covenant shall be manifested unto them. Mine eyes are ever toward the Lord, for he it is that will draw my feet out of the snare. Look upon me and have mercy on me, for I am one only begotten and poor. The afflictions of my heart are multiplied. Bring me out from my necessities. Behold my loneliness and my toil, and forgive all my sins. Look upon mine enemies, for they are multiplied, and with an unjust hatred have they hated me. Keep my soul and rescue me. Let me not be put to shame, for I have hoped in thee. The innocent and the upright have cleaved unto me, for I have waited on thee, O Lord. Redeem Israel, O God, out of all his afflictions. Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy, and according to the multitude of thy compassion. Blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from mine iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know mine iniquity, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee only have I sinned, and done this evil before thee, that thou mightest be justified in thy words, and prevail when thou art judged. For behold, I was conceived in iniquities, and in sins did my mother bear me. For behold, thou wantest truth, the hidden and secret things of thy wisdom thou hast made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made whiter than snow. Thou shalt make me to hear joy and gladness. The ones that have been humbled, they shall rejoice. Turn thy face from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities, creating me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and with thy governing spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressors thy ways, and the ungodly shall turn back unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, thou God of my salvation, and my tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For if thou hadst desired sacrifice, I'd have given it. With whole burnt offerings thou shalt not be pleased. The sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit, a heart that is broken and humbled thou wilt not despise. Do good, O Lord, and I give pleasure unto Zion, and let the walls of Jerusalem be built. Then thou wilt be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with oblation and whole burnt offerings. Then they will offer bullocks upon thine altar. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Let us the faithful praise and worship the Word, co-eternal with the Father and the Spirit, born for our salvation from the Virgin. For he willed to be lifted up on the cross in the flesh, to endure death and to raise the dead by his glorious resurrection. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Thou hast revealed the beauty of thy holy dwelling place, of thy glory on earth, to be like the splendor of the heavenly firmament, O Lord. Through the prayers of the Theotokos, strengthen it forever and ever, and accept our supplication, which we ceaselessly offer thee therein, the life and resurrection of all, both now and ever, and through the ages of ages. Amen. O Theotokos, thou art the true vine that hath blossomed forth for us the fruit of life. The Thee do we supplicate, intercede, O Lady, together with the holy apostles, that our souls find mercy. Blessed is the Lord God, blessed is the Lord day by day, the God of our salvation shall prosper us along the way. Our God is the God of salvation. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, wash away our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities. For thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Amen. Thou didst descend into hell, O my Savior, shattering its gates as Almighty, resurrecting the dead as Creator and destroying the sting of death. Thou hast delivered Adam from the curse, O lover of men, and we cry to thee, O Lord, save us. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. Now who at all times and at every hour in heaven and on earth art worshipped and glorified, O Christ God, who art long suffering, plenteous in mercy, most compassionate. Who lovest the righteous and hast mercy on sinners, who callest all to salvation through the promise of good things to come. Receive, O Lord, our prayers at this hour, and guide our life toward thy commandments. Sanctify our souls, make chaste our bodies, correct our thoughts, purify our intentions, and deliver us from every sorrow, evil, and pain. Help us about with thy holy angels that guarded and guided by their array. We may attain to the unity of the faith and the knowledge of thine unapproachable glory. For blessed art thou unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim, and beyond compare, more glorious than the seraphim, who without corruption gave birth to God, the Word of the very veil, to us, thee we magnify. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless. Amen. O Master God, the Father Almighty, the Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, and O Holy Spirit, one Godhead, one power, have mercy on me, a sinner, and pardon the judgments which thou knowest, save me, thine unworthy servant, for blessed art thou unto the ages and ages. Amen. Come, let us worship God our King. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ our King and God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and our God. O God, in thy name save me, and in thy strength do thou judge me. O God, hearken unto my prayer, give ear unto the words of my mouth. For strangers have risen up against me, and mighty men have sought after my soul, and have not set God before themselves. For behold, God helpeth me, the Lord is the protector of my soul. He will bring evils upon mine enemies, utterly destroy them by thy truth. Willingly shall I sacrifice them to thee. I will confess thy name, O Lord, for it is good, for out of every affliction hast thou delivered me, and mine eye hath looked down upon my enemies. Give ear, O God, unto my prayer, disdain not my supplication, attend unto my hearing. I was grieved at my meditation, and I was troubled at the voice of the enemy, and at the oppression of the sinner, because they have turned iniquity upon me, and with wrath were they angry against me. My heart is troubled within me, and the terror of death has fallen upon me. Fear and trembling are come upon me, and darkness hath covered me. And I said, Who will give me wings like a dove, and I will fly and be at rest? Lo, I have fled far off, and dwelt in the wilderness. I waited for God that saveth me from faint-heartedness and from tempest. Plunge them into the depths, O Lord, and divide their tongues, for I have seen iniquity and gainsaying in the city. Day and night they go round about upon her walls, iniquity and toil and unrighteousness are in the midst of her, and usury and deceit have not departed from her streets. For if mine enemy ever found me, I might have endured it, and if he that hateth me had spoken those death come upon such ones, and let them go down alive into Hades, for wickedness is in their bones and in the midst of them. As for me, and the God of my cry, the Lord hearkened unto me. Evening, morning, and noon, day will I tell of it, and will declare it, and he will hear my voice. He will redeem my soul in peace from them that draw nigh unto me, for they among many were with me. God will hear, and he will humble them, he that is before the ages, for to them there is no requital, because they have not feared God. He hath stretched forth his hand in retribution, they have defiled his covenant. They were scattered by the wrath of his countenance, and their hearts have convened. Their words were smoother than oil, and yet they are darts. Cast thy care upon the Lord, and he will nourish thee. He will never permit the righteous to be shaken. But thou, O God, shalt bring those men down into the pit of destruction. Bloody and deceitful men shall not live out half their days. But as for me, O Lord, I will hope in thee. He that dwelleth in the house of the Most High shall abide in the shelter of the God of heaven. He shall say unto the Lord, thou art my helper and my refuge. He is my God, and I will hope in him. For he shall deliver thee from the snare of the front hunters and from every troubling bird. With his shoulders will he overshadow thee, and under his wings shalt thou have hope. With a shield will his truth encompass thee. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the thing that walketh in darkness, nor for the mishap and demon of noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but unto thee it shall not come nigh. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold, and thou shalt see the reward of sinners, for thou, O Lord, art my hope. Thou madest the Most High thy refuge, no evil shall come nigh thee, and no scourge shall draw nigh unto thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. On their hands shall they bear thee up, lest at any time thou dash thy foot against the stone. Upon the asp and the basilisk shalt thou tread, and thou shalt trample upon the lion and the dragon. For he hath set his hope on me, and I will deliver him. I will shelter him, because he hath known my name. He shall cry unto me, and I will hearken unto him. I am with him in affliction, and I will rescue him and glorify him. With length of days will I satisfy him, and I will show him my salvation. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and through the ages and ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy. Let us the faithful praise and worship the Word, come eternal with the Father and the Spirit, born for our salvation from the Virgin, for his will to be lifted up on the cross of the flesh to endure death, and to raise the dead by his glorious resurrection. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Thou hast revealed the beauty of the holy dwelling place of thy glory on earth, to be like the splendor of the heavenly firmament, O Lord. Through the prayers of the Theotokos, strengthen it forever and ever, and accept our supplication, which we ceaselessly offer thee therein, the life and resurrection of all, both now and ever, and to the ages and ages on earth. Seeing that we have no boldness on account of our many sins, do thou beseech him that was born of the other to the Theotokos, for the supplication of the mother of Elek, much to the master's favor. Disdain not the prayers of sinners, of all pure ones, are merciful and mighty to save the sea, who deigned also to suffer for our sake. Let thy compassions quickly go before us, O Lord, for we are become exceedingly poor. Help us, O God, our Savior, for the sake of the glory of thy name. O Lord, deliver us and be gracious of our sins, for our name, for thy name's sake. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages and ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, blot out our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit the healer and from the peace for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name, and thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine are the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. The church has been revealed to be a heaven filled with light, which enlightens all the faithful, standing within it, we cry, establish this house, O Lord. Lord, have mercy, 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 L Lord of mercy, have mercy. Now, will at all times and at every hour in heaven and on earth, have worship and glorified, O Christ, God, who art long suffering, plenteous in mercy, most compassionate, who lovest the righteousness, mercy on sinners, who call us all to salvation through the promise of good things to come. Receive, O Lord, our prayers at this hour, and guide our lives with thy commandments, sanctify our souls, make chaste our bodies, correct our thoughts, purify our intentions, and deliver us from every sorrow, evil, and pain. Comes us about with thy holy angels, that guided and guarded by their array, we may attain to the unity of the faith and the knowledge of thy unapproachable glory. For blessed art thou unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim and beyond compare, more glorious than the seraphim, who without corruption gave us birth to God the Word, the very Theotokos, thee we magnify. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
Through the prayers of our holy fathers, O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen. O God and Lord of hosts, and maker of creation, who by the tender compassion of thy mercy, transcendent comprehension, didst send down thy only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, the salvation of our race, and by this precious blood, didst spare us under the handwriting of our sins, and thereby didst triumph over the prince of evil.
Bless, Master.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and to the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, for those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Tikhon, Archbishop Benjamin, for the honorable priesthood and the diaconate in Christ, and for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this country, its president, for all civil authorities, and for the armed forces, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and countryside, and for faithful dwelling in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For seasonable weather, for the abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by land, by sea, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating a most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Unto thee, O Lord, unto thee unto all glory, honor, and worship. the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen. As the Lord, O my soul, blessed art thou, O Lord. As the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all that he hath done for thee. Bless the Lord, O his works, in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Blessed art thou, Lord.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating the most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Laethe, Tokos, and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
To
thine is the majesty, and thine are the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord, O my soul. I will praise the Lord in my life. I will chant unto my God for as long as I have my being. Trust ye not in princes, in the sons of men, in whom there is no salvation. The Lord preserveth the proselytes, he shall lift up for his only orphaned widow, and the way of sinners shall he destroy. The Lord shall be king unto eternity. My God, O Zion, unto generation and generation. Now and ever and unto ages of ages, amen. Holy begotten Son and immortal Word of God, who for our salvation is well to be incarnate of the Holy Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, who without change is become and was crucified. O Christ our God, trembling down death by death, who art one of the Holy Trinity, glorified with the Father and the Holy Spirit, save us.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorating the most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Mankind, and unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Blessed.
wisdom, let us attend.
Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, O Son of God, who rose from the dead, save us, to sing to thee, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Let us, as people, praise and worship the Word, Christ, who are the Father and the Spirit, born for our salvation from the Virgin. For he wills to be lifted up on the cross in the flesh, to endure death and to raise the dead by his glorious resurrection. Thus reveal the beauty of the holy dwelling place of thy glory on earth, to be like the splendor of a heavenly firmament, O Lord, through the prayers of the Theotokos, strengthen it forever and forever, and accept our supplication, which we ceaselessly offer to thee therein, the life and resurrection of all. We offer in supplication the life-creating cross of thy goodness, O Lord, which thou hast granted to us, although we are unworthy, through the Theotokos, able or perhaps Christians, O only lover of mankind. Glory to the to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The church has been revealed to be a heaven filled with light, which enlightens all the faithful. Standing within it, we cry, establish this house, holy God, holy mighty.
to all.
And to thy spirit, the prokimenon in the sixth tone. O Lord, save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
O Lord, save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Thine inheritance.
To thee, O Lord, will I call. O my God, be not silent to me.
O Lord, save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
In the fourth tone, holiness befits thy house, O Lord, forevermore.
Holiness befits thy house, O Lord, forevermore.
Wisdom.
The reading from the epistle of the Holy Apostle Paul to the Galatians.
Let us attend.
Brethren, see how large a letter I have written unto you with mine own hand. As many as desire to make a good showing in the flesh, these try to compel you to be circumcised, only that they may not suffer persecution for the cross of Christ. For not even they themselves who are circumcised keep the law, but they desire to have you circumcised, that they may glory in your flesh. But God forbid that I should glory except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom the world has been crucified unto me, and I unto the world. For in Christ Jesus neither circumcision availeth anything, nor uncircumcision, but a new creation. And as many as walk according to this rule, peace be on them, and mercy, and upon the Israel of God. From now on let no one trouble me, for I bear in my body the marks of the Lord Jesus. Brethren, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with your spirit. Amen. Now he who establishes us with you in Christ, and has anointed us, is God, who has also sealed us and given us the Spirit in our hearts as a deposit. Moreover, I call God as witness against my soul, that to spare you I came no more to Corinth. Not that we have dominion over your faith, but are helpers for your joy, for by faith you stand. But I determined this within myself, that I would not come again to you in sorrow. For if I make you sorrowful, then who is he who makes me glad but the one who is made sorrowful by me? And I wrote this very thing unto you, lest when I came I should have sorrow over those from whom I ought to have joy, having confidence in you all that my joy is the joy of you all. For out of much affliction and anguish of heart I wrote unto you with many tears, not that you should be grieved, but that you might know the love which I have so abundantly for you. And to thy spirit,
wisdom.
The Alleluia in the first tone, I have exalted one chosen out of my people.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
For my hand shall defend him, and my arm shall strengthen him. Foundations are in the holy mountains. The Lord loveth the gates of Jerusalem.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Blessed Master, him who proclaims glad tidings, the holy apostle and evangelist Matthew.
Pray God through the prayers of the holy, glorious, laudable apostle and evangelist Matthew. Enable thee to proclaim to God tithes of great power and fulfillment of the gospel of his beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. Wisdom, let us attend. Let us hear the holy gospel.
Peace be unto all.
And to your spirit.
Let us hear the holy gospel. The readings from the holy gospel. according to St. Matthew.
Let us be attentive.
Glory to thee, O Lord. Glory to thee.
Let us attend.
The Lord said this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a certain king who arranged a marriage for his son and sent out his servants to call those who were invited to the wedding, and they were not willing to come. Again, he sent out other servants, saying, tell those who are invited, see, I have prepared my dinner. My oxen and fatted cattle are killed. All things are ready. Come to the wedding. But they made light of it and went their ways, one to his own farm, another to his business, and the rest seized his servants, treated them spitefully, and killed them. But when the king heard about it, he was furious, and he sent out his armies, destroyed those murderers, and burned up their city. Then he said to his servants, the wedding is ready, but those who were invited were not worthy. Therefore go into the highways, as many as you find, invite to the wedding. So those servants went out into the highways and gathered together all whom they found, both bad and good, and the wedding hall was filled with guests. But when the king came in to see the guests, he saw a man there who did not have on a wedding garment. So he said to him, friend, how did you come in here without a wedding garment? And he was speechless. Then the king said to the servants, bind him hand and foot, take him away, and cast him into utter darkness. There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth, for many are called, but few are chosen. The Lord said, no one has ascended to heaven, but he who came down from heaven, that is, the Son of Man who is in heaven. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that through the world, through him, might be saved.
Glory to thee, O Lord. Glory to thee.
Christ is in our midst. Let me begin this morning by reading a passage from the first epistle of St. Peter, chapter 4, where he says, beloved, do not think it strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened to you. And I read that and I thought, boy, that, you know, talk about a fiery trial. We're really going through that on the West Coast. But he goes on to say, but rejoice to the extent that you partake of Christ's sufferings, that when his glory is revealed, you may also be glad with exceeding joy. Now, I wouldn't presume to compare what we're going through today with the sufferings that the early Christians had to endure, where, you know, every day they were faced with persecution and death for practicing their faith. But I would like us to consider what our response should be when our faith is tested, as it is being tested in these days. St. Paul in Romans chapter 5 says this, we also glory in tribulations, knowing that tribulation produces perseverance, and perseverance produces character, and character produces hope. Now, I'll be honest, when I look around at our tribulations today, I don't see a whole lot of glorying going on, especially not on social media. But I have to ask myself,
some questions as well. Is tribulation leading me to persevere? Is tribulation building Christian character in me? And what about hope? Are we seeing a lot of hope? Am I hopeful that despite what's going on around us, that that God is still in control? The Lord is giving us an opportunity to repent. Is that what we're doing? Or are we instead pointing fingers and complaining? I was reading this past week about the flu epidemic of 1918, which closed churches across the country for many, many months. Churches were closed. And do you know what was different about how people reacted then compared to now? Nothing. Nothing was different. We see the same reactions then as we're seeing now. There was some fear, there was some anger, hopelessness, even defiance. And yet, at the same time, there were also many who continued to give thanks even in the midst of their tribulation. There were many expressions of Christian love and charity, just as we're seeing today. And you know, they didn't even have internet, so they couldn't live stream their church services. What happened was a clergy in a lot of churches, every week they would print out copies of the service and of their sermons, and they would distribute those to all of the members of their parishioners. So it was a difficult time, just like it is today. And yet somehow they persevered. Christians persevered. They stayed with it. The churches eventually were opened and people came back. So what I was thinking, how do we encourage one another during these difficult times? What is it that keeps us together? Now, those of you who are closer to my age will remember that song, popular song, Love Will Keep Us Together. Father Ian certainly will remember that. Now, I know they were talking about a different kind of love, but there's a truth there, that love does keep us together. In fact, St. Paul says that love is the perfect bond of unity, Christian love. But if love is the bond of our unity, what is the basis of our unity? Let me suggest a couple of things. Number one, the cross of Christ. We gather together at the foot of the cross. Now, you've heard me say this many times. You know, we think that what we're going through today with the pandemic and the fires and all that, we think it's hard. You know what was hard? The cross was hard. What Jesus did in sacrificing himself for us on the cross, that was hard. And yet, God transformed that instrument of torture into the means of our salvation so that now we venerate, what, the precious and life-giving cross. The world meant it for evil, but God meant it for good. So the cross today we beautify and we honor and we venerate as precious and life-giving. Looking to the cross on which Jesus died for us. And at the same time, we're called to take up our own cross and follow him. And it's important to remember that we do this voluntarily. The cross is something that we take up voluntarily. You know, I've heard people say in our current tribulation, well, I guess this is just the cross that we have to bear. But that's not really true. Because the cross is not something we have to bear, it's something that we voluntarily take up. When we sacrifice ourselves for the sake of others, when we sacrifice our time and our resources and our comfort and convenience for the sake of other people, that's what it means to voluntarily take up the cross. In the liturgy, we hear what? In the night in which Jesus was given up, or rather gave himself up for the life of the world. He took up his cross when he went to his voluntary death. The sacrifices we make voluntarily for the sake of other people may be small compared to the great sacrifice that Jesus made on the cross, but yet they are important for our life together. So let's not forget, brothers and sisters, that that when we're called to make sacrifices of whatever, and we do that voluntarily, that's part of what it means to follow Christ. And then secondly, the Eucharist is the basis for our unity. St. Paul says in 1 Corinthians that there should be no divisions among us when we come together because we share in the one cup. And thankfully today we can still share in the Eucharist together. Now I realize things look a bit different, we're doing things a bit differently, but the important thing is that we are still receiving the body and blood of Christ together, sharing in the one cup. That is the basis for our unity. This fulfills our oneness in Christ. I love this quote from Father Smemann. He said, "The Orthodox Church is full of petty personal arguments, but at the heart of it remains an unshakable belief that the world is transformed by the celebration of the Eucharist." And how true that is. The gospel reading that we heard this morning from Matthew, you know, Jesus gives us the parable about the marriage feast and people being invited. And this foreshadows, of course, the great marriage feast of the Lamb in the age to come. But we have a foretaste of that great marriage feast right here on earth when we celebrate the Eucharist. That is our invitation to come and to participate in the great marriage feast of the Lamb. And we, none of us are worthy, of course, but because we are clothed in the righteousness of Christ, which happens at our baptism, that is the clothing that we have when we, you know, get to that heavenly feast. Not clothed in our own good deeds and our own righteousness, but in the righteousness of Christ. And we experience a foretaste of that today. So brothers and sisters, as we come together today at the foot of the cross to partake together of the one cup, let us consider how we might encourage one another toward love and good works. Christ is in our midst.
Let us all say with all our soul, with all our mind, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord Almighty, to God of our fathers, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to thy great mercy, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for our Metropolitan Tikhon, for Archbishop Benjamin, for priests, deacons, and all other clergy, and for all our brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for this country, its president, for all civil authorities, and for the armed forces.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the blessed and ever-memorable Holy Orthodox Patriarchs, and for the blessed and ever-memorable founders of this Holy Church, for all our fathers and brethren, the Orthodox who parted this life before us, Archpriest Paul, Deacon Gregory, Katrina, Dennis, Catherine, Radu, David, John, Carolyn, Vera, Karzivan, Vidad, Raida, Olga, Zoya, Michael, Mark, who here in all the world lie sleeping the Lord.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation for the servants of God, all those suffering from the coronavirus, all those impacted by the wildfires, Archpriest Ian and Matuska Nina, Archpriest Michael, Archpriest David and Alice, St. Silouan Mission, Deacon Joseph, Matuska Priscilla, Deacon Seraphim and Matuska Susan, Joanne, Catherine, Linda, Karen, Alexandra, Jean and Cheryl, Marie, Louis Andrew, Michaela, Joseph, Christiana, Curtis, Bernie, Mary Lou, Ann, Kent, Bruce, Olga, Elizabeth, Jamie, Gregory, Evelyn, Catherine, Bob, Svitlana, Macrina, Elena, Dan, Dorothea, Irenaeus, Monica, Gary, Lori, Wichald, Hannah, Kathy, Matuska, Joni, Amanda, Elizabeth, Sarah, Kimberly, and for the brethren of this holy temple, and for the pardon and remission of their sins.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for those who bring offerings and do good works in this holy and all venerable temple, for those who labor and those who sing, and for all the people here present, who await thy great and rich mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Thou art a merciful God, who lovest mankind, and unto thee do we send our glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Pray to the Lord, ye catechumens. Let us, the faithful, pray for the catechumens, that the Lord may have mercy on them, that he may teach them the word of truth, that he may reveal to them the gospel of righteousness, that he may unite them to his holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. Save them, have mercy on them, help them, and keep them, O God, by thy grace. Bow your heads unto the Lord, ye catechumens.
But with us thou also may glorify the honorable and majestic name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto me, just as it
is.
All catechumens depart, depart, catechumens. All that are catechumens depart. Let no catechumen remain. Let us, the faithful, again and again in peace, pray unto the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above, and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, for those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom.
That God did always by thy might, you may send up glory to thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Please.
and sisters in Christ.
God bless you.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, forgive me my sins and offenses.
Archbishop of Washington, D.C., Metropolitan of all America and Canada. May the Lord our God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. The Most Reverend Benjamin, Archbishop of San Francisco in the West. May the Lord our God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
For all those in priestly and monastic orders, may the Lord our God remember them in his heavenly kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the President of the United States and all civil authorities, and for our armed forces in defense of peace and freedom everywhere, may the Lord our God remember them in his heavenly kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
For all those who departed this life in true faith and the hope of the resurrection, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For all those Christians who are suffering persecution for the faith throughout the world, especially in the Middle East and Africa, may the Lord God remember his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For all those who are sick and suffering, all those suffering from the coronavirus, all those who are suffering and from the wildfires, all those in hospitals, nursing homes, institutions, may the Lord God remember his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. The founders and benefactors of this holy house, for those who labor, for those who sing, for those who serve, for all those whom we have in our hearts, may the Lord God remember his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. You and all those who love you, may the Lord God remember his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Oh.
Let us complete our prayer unto the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
With the precious gifts now offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
With his holy house, for those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
That the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord.
Bless this, O Lord.
An angel of peace, a faithful guide and guard of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
All things that are good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
A Christian ending to our life, painless, blameless, and peaceful, and a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Grant this, O Lord.
Commemorating the most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
Through the compassions of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thine all-holy good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
Let us love one another, that with one mind we may confess.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the Trinity, one in essence, God the divine.
The doors in wisdom, let us attend.
I believe one God the Father Almighty.
Thank you.
stand with fear, let us attempt that we may offer the holy oblation in peace.
Spirit be with all of you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us lift up our hearts.
We lift up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord. Archangels and hosts of angels, the cherubim and the serpent, six winged minyatos, who soar aloft, borne on their pinions, singing the triumphant hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
Holy, 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 Lord of sorrow, heaven and earth are full of thy glory.
These blessed powers.
Virgin Mary. It is truly
for Archbishop Benjamin, grant unto the Holy Church the peace and the honor, health and length of days, righteous to divide the word of thy truth.
And all mankind.
And grant that with one mouth, one heart, may glorify and praise and honor the majestic name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and through the ages of ages.
Amen.
May the mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Having remembered all the saints, again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Precious gifts now offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That our God, who loves mankind, having received them upon his holy and poetic altar above the heavens as a sweet spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
That the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
An angel of peace, a faithful guide and guard of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
Pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
All things that are good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord. That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
A Christian ending to our life, painless, blameless, and peaceful, and a good defense before the judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Grant us, O Lord.
Having asked for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
And make us worthy, O Master, that with boldness and without condemnation, we may dare to call on thee, the heavenly God, as Father, and to say,
unto all.
And to your spirit.
Bow your heads unto the Lord.
To thee, O Lord.
Through the grace and compassion and love for mankind, thy only begotten Son, of God, together with thou, Holy Good and Life, Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Let us attend
the holy things of God. talking about. I need to be with him and you are taking the Lord's body. The Lord will not do it. Jesus Christ, permission of my sins. Forgive me, brothers and sisters in Christ. Together, I believe,
O Lord, and I confess that thou art truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners from my errors. I have you also this true and own most pure body, and this is true and own precious blood. Therefore, I pray thee, have mercy upon me, and forgive me my transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary, of word and deed, and in knowledge of goodness, and make me worthy to partake without condemnation of thy most pure mysteries, for the remission of my sins and the life everlasting. Amen. Let me just suffer for us, my God, accepting today's communion, for I must speak of thy mysteries and thy enemies, not that of Jews, so I give thee a kiss, the life of thee, the life of thy seed. Remember me, Lord, in thy kingdom, may the kingdom of the Lord just be not under my judgment, nor is my condemnation, O Lord.
Truth doctrine in men's souls through the Spirit.
and the fear of God, with faith and love draw near.
Remember, brothers and sisters, that in order to receive Holy Communion Orthodox Church, you must be an Orthodox Christian and should have prepared through prayer, fasting, and regular practice of confession. Again, numbers, as you draw forward, to please keep 6 feet distance between each other in line, and to take one of the paper towels as you come forward. Thank you. save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
We have seen the true light, we have received the heavenly Spirit. We have found the true faith, worshiping the divine Trinity, who has saved us.
Always now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Let us declare thy praise, O Lord, that we may sing of thy glory. For thou hast made us worthy to partake of thy holy, divine, immortal, and unfading mysteries. Keep us in thy holiness. Hallowed all the day we may meditate upon thy righteousness. Alleluia, alleluia,
having partaken of the divine, holy, most pure, immortal, heavenly, life-giving, and awesome mysteries of Christ, let us worthily give thanks unto the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace, asking that the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless. Let us commend ourselves and each other in all our lives unto Christ our God. Sanctification, and unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Let us depart in peace.
In the name of the Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, who blesses those who bless thee and sanctifies those who trust in thee, save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Preserve the fullness of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house. Glorify them in return by thy divine power. And forsake us not who put our hope in thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to thy priests, to all those in civil authority, to the armed forces, and to all thy people. For every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from thee, the Father of lights, and unto thee do we send up glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore.
Life-giving cross, the holy, glorious, and all laudable apostles, of our Father among the Saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, of our Father among the Saints, our Martyr Cornelius, whose memory keep this day, the Holy Rogers, Ion, Zilson, God, Joachim, and of all the Saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good in us, mankind.
Amen. His Beatitude, the Most Blessed Deacon, Archbishop of Washington, Metropolitan of all America and Canada, His Eminence, the Most Reverend Benjamin, Archbishop of San Francisco and the West, the President of the United States of America and all those in authority, of this holy temple, and Orthodox Christians, O Lord, preserve them for many years.
Christ is in our midst.
He is ever shall be.
You may be seated for announcements, brothers and sisters. I want to first of all welcome you all who are with us this morning, praying together in person, and those who are praying at home. Again, a joy to be together around the Lord's table, celebrating the Holy Eucharist. Thanks be to God for the word of edification, encouragement for Father Tom today. We are in the forefeast now of the elevation of the Holy Cross, the beginning of our parish's altar feast, which is a great joy. And isn't it beautiful even here, brothers and sisters? I want to give thanks to God for all of you who helped yesterday, beautifying the grounds, helping. We now have this lovely windbreak, don't we, too? And even the flowers, we have these beautiful garlands that we've worked so hard on. So thank you to all who contributed and worked on that yesterday at our work day. Number of announcements this week. First, a note regarding our feast day services. We will have a vigil at 6 p.m. this evening out here in the pavilion as well, and Divine Liturgy will be here in the pavilion tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. Just a note on the tomorrow during the liturgy, we'll have a collection for our building program, as we weren't able to have other fundraisers for it. We celebrate our parish's feast, we still look to the future and the building up of our church. Welcome back and congratulations to Melissa and Caleb. I saw them. So, well, there they are, the newlyweds. Congratulations. Good to have you with us again. I think we have one more week as well before we make the move out to Mississippi. So good to have you with us again. Maybe in a week we can kind of... No, we won't keep you here, will we? But we'd like to. please keep Aquila and Thomas in your prayers. The Aquila, they're getting ready to be married next weekend. So that's a joy coming up very quickly. So please keep them in your prayers as they prepare for their marriage in Novato next weekend. Also, of course, as we have very visible reminders of the wildfires continuing to go on throughout the state and indeed throughout the West Coast, please keep everyone who's affected by that in your prayers. I've heard of a number of cases, and within our diocese, there were a number of families in Oregon who lost homes. Within California, I don't know of any within our diocese, but in others, there certainly have been, and many people have lost their homes. I had heard of it in Felton, a priest, Silawam and Presbyterian Xenia had lost their home, and others, and I know there are a number of others, so please do keep all of this, that this may end quickly. And of course, we have, as we say, the smoke is that reminder, so we can, seeing that, we can turn to prayer for all of those who are suffering right now. Otherwise, with the schedule, of course, the feast day being the main thing on the schedule this week, as we go ahead, it will be somewhat usual food calls on Tuesday. Wednesday evening, we'll have our small complement Orthodox Faith and Life class. Those who want to jump in, if we're still online, we're beginning a study of Abba Dorotheus, his kind of a primer on the spiritual life, if you will. And so we're going to be going through those discourses over the coming weeks. I do have questions going ahead for those who participate in the Wednesday class, if we have the opportunity to come back to in person, if you would still like to continue just online for a time, or you're anxious to get back in person and be able to reach different audiences in different ways. And so if you have feelings about that, please do let me know. Thursday morning, we'll have Psalms and Scripture readings online, and then our regular weekend services next weekend. Anything else before many years? Okay, Father Deacon.
Yes, last week on the 7th, I missed Nathan and Amanda Brown anniversary. On the 8th, Father Bill Weir, Matuska Marianne have an anniversary. And also on the 8th, Russell Bartnick has a birthday. This week, on the 13th, Olympia Zapalos has a birthday. John Cave has a birthday. On the 14th, Nathan Renfrey has a birthday. Subdeacon Brett John and Allison Gaynor, anniversary. On the 17th, Janice Cedarborg has a names day. Rachel Vera Duke has a names day. Vera Lineback has a names day. On the 19th, Warren Green has a birthday. And Don Haywood has a birthday.
Today is Carl Wessenfeld's birthday.
Oh. Carl?
Carl.
Last week we missed Lori Shadoff's birthday on the 9th.
Sit on the 9th?
Mm-hmm. And Josh had one more.
Sabrina Hope's name's good this week.
What day?
The
okay. So it'd be 17. Names day. Okay. Grant, O Lord, a prosperous, peaceful life, health, salvation, and furtherance. Enough blessed things upon thy servants, Nathan, Amanda, Father Bill, Matuska, Marianne, Russell, Olympia, John, Nathan, Subdeacon Brett, John, Allison, Janice, Rachel, Vera, Warren, Don, Carol, Lori, Sabrina, and preserve them for many years.
Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee, O God.